Let's now look at the functions and programs in Python. This is a general structure of any Python programs. For easier readability and for easier debugging, any program needs to be in a modular fashion. So that is why there are different functions are defined initially, and these functions are then called later in the main program. So this can be kind of replicated through an example. That is what I have done here. So just define the function, and I am returning the value as answer. Do note the indentation here. This is very critical in Python, because in Python, if you make error in indentation, again, it's quite difficult sometimes to debug, and sometimes Python itself say indentation wrong, there is a wrong indentation. In other programming language, generally you will find either begin end statement or you will have the braces for begin and end. Here it is through indentation. So that is the difference. So now let us see the example. I have keyed in the function already. Here this one. Look at it, this one. Define the power xn or the parameters. And so initially I'm setting it to 1. Post that, yeah, for the range of how many ever times you want to calculate the power, that is the n value, it calculates the answer. The ans variable keeps updating for that many number of times, and finally once it is out of the loop, the answer is returned back. That is where power of 2 to the power of 3 is 8, and you see power of 2 to the power 2 is 4, and power of 5 to the power of 2 is 25, power of 5 to the power of 3 is 125. So now we come to the end of this session on the functions. Thank you.